My life purpose, I felt, was because my mom in energy in clairvoyance, she told me, you'll always earn for something, like long. So I thought, why is she being insulting? Like, you know, this was like right after she died, like 1987, she died. So I had an intense connection within a month with her. And from the other side, she said that. And after 21 years working on myself, like, you know, my teacher and stuff, finally dawned on me last week when I did the meditation. My life purpose is to understand the emotion longing, what it feels like, you know. So that's why I listen to you guys, because what it is it takes, like, that is to bring back emotionally to understand what is to be longing to be accepted as a family. That's what Jen is also doing, right? It is a specific hope muscle we are developing. Remember that. Like, you know, see, everybody works out.
Yeah.
We are working on the emotional muscle. So to do that, first you need to take that hurt and then heal the hurt. So if you understand that, then you can release. See, what we are doing is we take the hurt, but we never release it. We mask it by using medication and stuff. So what I understood when I understood, oh, so that's my life purpose. So it makes sense. People always make me long for that love. Because I actually went to a Chinese restaurant in my town. It's called Jinjiling or something. I was just asking that lady in the front, what's your name? Do you know she refused to tell me, and she was very insulting. And I was thinking, why? Because they see me with dreads. They have no idea who I am. And they feel it's beneath them to talk to me. Just like how you said, like, because people judge you for your appearance. But the weird part is, right, the minute they know your titles, they are like always, like, you know, like coming across. So, but when you see how they treat you when you're nothing, versus how when you're something, you always base it on how you treated when they were nothing, right? Same thing, the table will switch, tell Jen that, because the exact brother who didn't invite her would be able to see the truth in her at some point. And that time she needs to remember to be compassionate, because when the table reverses, our tendency is to be equally insulting. You know, so we need to, like, not forget we longed for this. So we long for this relationship. So like how kind of you said, in another way, you had a roommate who you knew how desperate they were. So you gave them a place, but then you could also see they were very sloppy. You couldn't deal with it. So even though we want to give them the world, they are not yet ready. You understand? So for me, the same thing, the longing that happened in me initially was causing hurt, like, you know, like with this lawyer who I gave money and she cheated me and stuff. But what I understood was, on my side, I'm coming across, if she doesn't pay me back, doesn't mean I need to take it against her. Still be compassionate, work through them, you know. So that's where I am at. But I'm so grateful for both success and failure. You understand? Like, only thing is, don't let it pull you down. Don't let it suck you in. And I'm so grateful you are there for Jen, because it takes a great man to stand by her side, because now she's going through the ups and downs, ups and downs, ups and downs, and it'll drive you nuts, I'm sure, right? She's using all your time. She's hogging your time. But remember, once upon a time, you longed for a companion like this, right? So it's like, so when you think about being grateful for even this torture, it makes you go to the next level. It's like almost you're playing a game. So you opened another door. That's the way it looked like. So I felt like I opened a portal on Friday, because I actually did all my tinctures. I showed you the rose. Because the rose is emotional healing. And it all fell into place because my son wanted a massage on Saturday. And so my husband paid for the massage. I was thinking, that's ridiculous, right? Kids wanting a massage. But I know, no, but he runs and stuff. So he wanted like, you know, deep tissue massage because his leg was like crappy.
Yeah.
But then I was late because he couldn't get a ride. So he calls, Mom, and I have like a million things planned, you know. So I go to pick him up. I told him, hey, you need to wait 20 minutes. He was so pissed off. So I told him, check out like local neighborhood, like hang there. So he said, Mom, can you go over to Save Us with me? And I'm saying, because I don't want to do shopping. So the minute we went in, he wanted a sweatshirt, two pairs of socks. I said, okay, I got sucked in. It was sweatshirt at least like $5 then. But I saw a tincture machine for $10. I said, oh my God, because my cord, I couldn't find my home for winter, I put it away. So when I came across this machine, it opened up another portal for me. So like by doing the right thing, right, for everybody, you also gain. I came home nonstop cooked. I got like 2 16-ounce jars. I am going to get it tested.
Yeah.
And I'm going to do rose tincture today or tomorrow.
Yeah, yeah.
And then now I have the whole formula for 3 years.
Wow, that's awesome.
So like, but that's, I could have been pissed off at him. I could have had an attitude. Like, you know, see what I'm saying is even little thing puts us ahead. Do you get it?
Yeah, we do get it.
Yes. So that's all I wanted to share. And I did it as a therapy because this can go in the camera for me.